Hey guys, welcome to the Trash Picture Show. I am back reviewing my last two G.I. Joe classified series figures that were sent to me by my gorgeous, fantastic, wonderful girlfriend, Jen Mitchell, aka Jen's Reviews from the Grave. Christian picked these up for me in Texas, and because he had a rake of stuff in his bag, he had to take the bubble casing off the card backs, but still, it's pretty awesome. He picked them up for me. It kicks arse. And the two figures we're going to be looking at are Destro, who is a Cobra agent, and Gung-Ho, who is part of the Joes. So the first figure I'm going to look at out of these two is Destro. Now, the cool thing is these were re-released from the first wave of Classified series, if I'm not mistaken. They were in a collector-friendly box, but they decided to re-release them in a retro style packaging. Essentially, this is the same design that the old packaging used to be in, but obviously in a larger scale because they are 6-inch figures. So, looking at Destro first, I'm going to have a quick look at the card back here. You got the picture of Destro. There he is. Essentially, Destro is an arms dealer. We'll get more into it on his file card at the back, but he's part of a science division in Cobra that manufactures and makes different kind of experimental weapons, and he is a more sci-fi character in the Joe universe. A lot of people are kind of torn between the latter G.I. Joe characters because they kind of done away with the regular military and geared more towards kind of fantastical and sci-fi characters. And I think Destro was the start of that. So yeah, again, really cool image of Destro there on the card. You have G.I. Joe Cobra enemy. Flip it to the back, and it shows the other characters you can get in the original retro style card figures. You can get Baroness. You can also get Lady J, Gung-Ho, who I have, and Destro. I actually have all these now, which is pretty cool. Although the other ones, Lady J wasn't in the retro card, Baroness was. So let's have a look at Destro's file card. So McCallan James, the 24th role, enemy weapons supplier, primary specialty weapons manufacturer, secondary specialty sabotage, birthplace unknown. Destro is the faceless power behind Mars, the largest manufacturer of state-of-the-art weaponry. And there you go, you got it in different languages, and you can cut out the actual file card and keep it if you want. So let's have a look at Destro and see what he is like. So again, as I said before, very sci-fi element to this character. He is definitely the most bombastic of the Cobra characters with his big silver head. That is cool. The collar, the black. He's got the belt with the M. The M stands, Mars is his company that makes and manufactures different weapons for Cobra. And yeah, it's pretty cool. Articulation wise, head can probably go all the way around. It's just the collar makes it a bit difficult. He comes with this pimp ass medallion. You can actually get a pimp version of Destro, which I think is funny. I'll flip it to the back there. Kind of just minimalistic kind of padding on the jacket and stuff. Articulation wise, the arms go up a nice bit, but not all the way. They do have a kind of butterfly joint there, but the actual gauntlets, the silver gauntlets, stop it from going all the way up. And leg wise, he can do the Van Damme's. Although I won't do too much because I don't want to break the holster and stuff here. And the butterfly joint on the knee does work there. And you have ankle rotation and heel rotation there. And again, nice character, minimalistic. And just the detail on the face, I just go into the face again. That's pretty cool. Silver head. So I just see someone going up to him trying to do up their makeup or checking their 5 o'clock shadow because he's his head's all reflective. Weapons wise, he comes with, again, very sci-fi character. So he comes with this laser pistol that would probably be more at home in Star Wars than G.I. Joe. But again, he makes experimental weapons. So that's pretty cool. Very sci-fi-esque. Just fit it into his hand there. Easy to fit in because there's no triggers to get it into. And he also comes with this little pistol here. And that can be put into the holster here. It's pretty cool. The last kind of major accessory he comes with is this case. It's got the Cobra logo on the front and the back. And does it open? We shall see. Hang on, I'm going to open it now. And we'll see what he's hiding. What is Destro hiding from us? And he has a shitload of cash and a computer. It's pretty cool. And you can fit that into this hand, if I'm not mistaken. And there we go. He has his case. His case for work. Destro's an interesting character, again, because he is an arms dealer. And he has actually screwed over Cobra Commander probably more times than the Joes. And it's obvious that he wants to control Cobra along with his lover, the Baroness. And they have tried time and time again to screw over Cobra Commander. They even have their own division of Cobras called the Crimson Guard, if I'm not mistaken. The last accessory he comes with is this cool standing plate. So if you want to put him on kind of just on display, you can put him onto this standing plate. And there he is. And again, it's a cool figure. And he's pretty badass. Destro is pretty cool. I don't know how I feel about his live action version. Christopher Eccleston, love the man. Fantastic doctor and fantastic actor. But I don't know, was he the right choice for Destro? Although there was a lot of issues with that movie. So I don't know, would Christopher Eccleston be the main reason that I'd have issue with that movie? But it didn't help. I think they really kind of miscast him. The other figure I'm going to look at is Gung-Ho. So I'm going to put Destro aside. And we're going to have a look at the very interesting character Gung-Ho. Or as I like to call him, Mr. Village People. Gung-Ho is part of the Marines. And I don't know if a member of the United States Marine Corps would be decked out like this, but I digress. Let's have a look at his file card first. So there he is, at a YMCA meeting, a Joe meeting, and yeah, he looks splendid, I think. There's the G.I. Joe logo, Gung-Ho, and yeah, my god, that man is hench. Right, flip it to the back. You got the same kind of stuff, the different characters in the vintage card back line. And then you have Gung-Ho. Entit or Lafitte. Roll Marine. I cannot pronounce his name. I'm just going to call him Gung-Ho. Primary Military Specialty. Recondo. Secondary Specialty. Jungle Warfare. Birthplace. Fair de Lance, L.A. And let's see. Born into a large back swamp. He's Cajun. That's why. I thought Christian may have come across. Somehow they accidentally put out a French version of him. But born into a large back swamp Cajun clan. Gung-Ho won the reputation of bare knuckle brawler. Joined the Marines at 18 and graduated top of his class from boot camp. So yeah, he's a Cajun. I don't know if any occasions out there are, is this your regular kind of dress code? Let me know in the comments below. But yeah, let's have a look at the figure. Let's have a look at Gung-Ho and everything he comes with. So the figure itself, Gung-Ho himself, is, let's see, here he is. And yeah, he's pretty cool, if not slightly homoerotic, and I'm probably not helping the situation by seeing if the, I'm going to check if the jacket comes off. I think the jacket can come off. Articulation wise, a bit better than Destro. Head can go all the way around. And yeah, really, really good kind of butterfly joints in this guy as well. So he actually has a bit better articulation than Destro. Butterfly joints in the legs there. Although he's a bit chunky, he's definitely the heaviest out of the classified figures I have. I'll see if I can take off the jacket. See if we can get this jacket off and make him even more fantabulous. Actually, do you know what? He looks cool without the jacket. He looks like Pat Roach in Raiders. He actually looks like the mechanic, the German mechanic in Raiders. I do like that. That's pretty cool. That is pretty awesome. I think he doesn't look as fantabulous without the jacket. But I'm going to put the jacket on, and we'll put him back the way he was. We'll put him back in village people mode, and get the jacket back on. That's pretty cool. He can take off the jacket to add to his more fantastic element, and it's June, it's Pride Month. I'm going to put on this hat. So yeah, in the Navy. Wait, he's a Marine. Sorry, I apologize. That hat, really, seriously, I can just see him doing YMCA. But yeah, no, it's a cool figure. It's still a cool figure. Again, this character is a throwback from the 80s. We also had He-Man. I mean, the amount of erotic, homoerotic subtext that was going on there. But it's still a pretty cool figure. I think it isn't helped by the teal color. Obviously, the original guy was this color as well. But yeah, it's cool. I do like the accessories. You got like different grenades on a bandolier there, and he's got two grenades strapped there, and he's got a holster and a knife that doesn't come out. A lot of these guys have knives that are cock teases. It's like, hey, can't take the blade out. So accessory wise, what's he come with? He comes with this big chunky backpack, which is like a throwback to the original backpacks that came with the Joes. And that goes through his jacket and into there. That's pretty cool. He also comes with this pistol, which looks like a kind of a Sig Sauer with an extended mag. And yeah, just pop it in there. And lastly, he comes with this, and it looks to be like some kind of pump action grenade launcher. I'm wondering, is it based off the Thumper from Vietnam? Or there was another one. What was it called? A China Lake? I think there was a pump action grenade launcher called a China Lake. I could be wrong. Again, I'm not the biggest gun aficionado. If anyone is there in the comments, let me know. And I'd really appreciate that. So let's put this weapon into his hand. Dun, dun. Get in there. Come on. Give me 1 second, guys. There we go. So he's fully kitted out. And lastly, he comes with, like Destro, a display stand with the Joes logo on it. So we're going to put him on here and have him standing. Stand into attention, Marine. There you go. That is pretty cool. He's pretty cool. He is a fantabulous looking figure. Not helped by the teal color, but I digress. Fuck it. Still pretty cool. Yeah. Who knows, you know? I know it's in the American military. We don't ask, so you don't tell. So, you know, maybe that's the case with Gung-Ho. But yeah, guys, I'm going to pause the video here, and I am going to do a size comparison between him and some other Joes. So don't go anywhere. I shall be right back. And we are back. And here is Destro and Gung-Ho in my alleyway. And I'm going to do some size comparisons. I am going to put Destro's love interest next to him. I'm going to put Baroness right there. And again, that really scales up nice. And them two, I'm going to take a couple of pictures together because they actually look really well together. And Gung-Ho, I was thinking, who would go with someone who looks like Gung-Ho? I think the Native American character would. I don't know. What do you think? Now, there we go. So yeah. It's really, really nice selection of figures. And again, Jane Mitchell, you are an absolute fucking legend. The best girlfriend on the planet. You're gorgeous, fantastic, and you spoiled me rotten. And Christian, thanks a million for picking these up. These guys kick ass. I'm going to do a big group shot, I think, with all my G.I. Joes, my old and new ones. And yeah. Again, this is a collection I never thought I'd end up having, but I do have. But yeah, guys, what do you think of Destro? Is he a bit too sci-fi for your liking? Do you prefer the more military-esque characters from G.I. Joe? And do you think Gung-Ho looks a bit too camp? Or do you think he is actually badass? Let me know in the comments below. And yeah, have a good one. Take care. Bye now.